Yeah, it's Luca coming to you live from East Bali, where I just got incredible news. In this world that we live in, I can't believe these things keep happening. But sorry, what? Why do we have to cut the service? What? Why? I have to tell you that the lens that I'm still using in 2024 is my best.
This is the Helios 44M. It's pretty much the same as a Helios 44-2, apart from the fact that it has 6 aperture blades instead of 8. To me, the image looks exactly the same, and I found this on a marketplace, so I snapped it. I still think that this lens is definitely the most cinematic out of all of the lenses that I own. I don't want to make the same video I made about a year ago on why do I love the Helios 44-2 or 44M or whatever version of the Helios you have. I already made that video, and I want to make something different, a bit more of like a why do I still use this lens? Why do I still think that this lens I'm shooting this video with, it's my favorite lens in all of the lenses that I own. And this is why I'm making this video. And the main factor has to be because of the reason that it's the most mass-produced lens in history of cameras, pretty much. This one Soviet lens has a very specific, muted Soviet look, if you would call it that way. And what does that mean is that the way the lens is built, the glass, the coating and everything allows this to get a very muted, very unique colors that when used in comparison with like a Sigma 24-70, for example, you can tell the difference so much more. The Sigma is perfect, it's clean, while the Helios, it's imperfect. It's not as sharp, it's a bit kind of wobbly in the corner, it's got these weird bokehs. It's different, and you definitely don't get the same image quality and detail and contrast within the two lenses. But this is why I love the Helios 44-2, because it allows me to get such a specific, unique look that for some artistic projects is what I'm chasing. And this is why this lens was used in movies such as The Batman and Dune, which are probably some of the most beautiful cinematography out there. The reason is because it's so unique. And being so unique, it's kind of hard to match to other lenses. And this is why whenever I shoot with this one lens, I have to be very careful, because if I'm shooting with this lens and then I'm using 45mm, for example, from RX or an Easy, or even a 24-70 from Sigma, I have to be very careful to include this lens only when it's needed and not all the time. Otherwise, it's going to be very hard to match and have the same color grade and look throughout the film without looking weird. Now, that is definitely a downside of having one of these Soviet lenses, is that they're hard to find and they're hard to match with other lenses unless you have a Soviet set. And unless you want to spend 30K on an iron glass rehoused Soviet set, the best bet is probably doing like me. Get the 44-2 first and then slowly build up your Soviet kit lens to 3, 4, 5 lenses. There are a few ones that match perfectly the vibe, the look, and even the bokehs of the 44-2. And some of these are the Mir 1A and 1V, which is a 20mm and a 37mm, I believe. And then we got the Helios, which is a 58mm. And then we got a Jupiter 9 or a Helios 42, which are 85mm. And now we got the TR 11A, I think it's called, which is a 135mm lens. Honestly, my goal is to own at least a wider lens, a 20 or a 37, for example, to match with the Helios, and then own an 85 and a 135. So I have a 3 to 4 set lenses to use in combined with this beautiful lens, because sometimes I just want to do a project where I don't have to care that much about the color looking so different within different scenes, and also the bokeh and everything within the scene. I don't want it to look that different between using a Sigma, for example, and a Helios. So I wish I had a Soviet set. So yeah, if you're looking to something to match the Helios, these are your options. But we're talking, why do I still love this lens? And I think aside from the bokeh, aside from the build quality, which is, you know, this lens is probably 50 to 60 years old, still looks beautiful, it's still pretty good shape, and who knows how many owners have this lens. This was made in Russia, and I bought this one in marketplace in Indonesia, so who knows how many owners this lens has had. yet look at this image, it's just beautiful. It doesn't matter how much this lens goes through, it's the build quality is incredible, and I wish some of today's gear was built like this, because honestly some of the lenses that I own kind of start to fall apart after a few years. Probably another beautiful factor about this lens, it's the bokeh, but not the bokeh that we all know, which is the swirly bokeh. You might actually be able to see it somewhere down here. The swirly bokeh on the corner, it's definitely something unique from the Helios and the Soviet lens in general, but that's not what I love that much about this lens. I love the fact that it looks almost anamorphic without giving too much away with these crazy flares. And you can even buy this lens mod up as anamorphic for that reason, because it's already such a lens that looks like anamorphic, it is so easy to mod to look anamorphic with flares and an oval disc inside pretty much. When I talk about the bokeh, I mean the foreground. Whenever there is an object in the foreground with this lens, the way the foreground blur mixes and matches with the frame and it falls out, it's just something very unique. And when compared to like a spherical classic lens like a Sigma, it's very different. I find this to be a lot more similar to anamorphic again. And this look is what I love. I love to add foreground and dirting up my lens when I shoot, and having something like this lens that helps me reach that cinematic look, to me is just a dream. So these are only some of the points of why I love this lens. Honestly, it's very hard to explain. I think everyone should have vintage lenses, as I said in previous videos, and everybody should own this one specific lens because it's just so beautiful and unique. So if you're thinking about buying a vintage lens, definitely start from the Helios and then move your way up and around it. Thank you so much for sticking around till the end, guys. If you do like this video, like and subscribe. It always doesn't hurt. Just a click, 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 done. Easy, support the channel, and see you guys in the next one.